Today's paper by Hanjong Han. Today's paper is ClinVar, Improving Access to Variant Interpretations and Supporting Evidence, published in 2017. ClinVar is one of the most widely used databases in the medical genetics field. There are other published articles about ClinVar database, but today's paper is about how ClinVar's data is organized and how it can be accessed. Before we begin, there's something you should know. Suppose you're interested in a certain human genetic disease. How would you get information about the disease and related genetic variants? Well, there are clinical laboratories and research groups around the world. They study and look for genetic variants associated with human diseases. However, each group encounters only a few diseases and related genetic variants. It would be really useful if this kind of research information could be gathered in one place. In this case, ClinVar is the database you want to find. Experts at the National Center for Biotechnology Information created an archive, called ClinVar. People at various groups submit their own research or clinical findings about human diseases and clinical significance of variants. People at ClinVar then collect and organize the information, according to their own criteria. The data can be searched and downloaded at the website. Currently, there are more than 800,000 variation records in ClinVar. Let's learn how ClinVar's data is organized and how it can be accessed one by one. Basically, the data in ClinVar is variant-centric. The people at ClinVar organize submission records by each genetic variant. There are three classes of identifiers: VCV, RCV, and SCV. VCV is for a variant, or a set of variants, and it contains all the information related to the variant. RCV is reference ClinVar accession number, and it contains information for each variant disease pair. SCV is an ID for each submitted record. So, there can be multiple submission records about each variant disease pair, and all the information of the SCVs are aggregated to each RCV. And, there can be multiple RCVs for a variant, regardless of the diseases, and they are aggregated to each VCV. Now you'd get the idea of the structure of ClinVar database. Next, provided data formats. ClinVar provides data in various formats. One of them introduced in this paper is XML. ClinVar provides two types of XML files, called ClinVar Variation Release and ClinVar Full Release. ClinVar Variation Release contains VCV-centric data, and ClinVar Full Release contains RCV-centric data. The files are released monthly basis, so you can track data addition and deletion of variant. ClinVar also provides VCF format files. VCF is a format of text files used in bioinformatics for storing gene sequence variations. The VCF files provided at ClinVar is allele-centric, and include all variants in ClinVar. VCF files basically contain chromosome numbers, genomic coordinates, a reference sequence, and an alternative sequence. The files at ClinVar contain additional information, such as clinical significance, allele frequency data, allele identifier, HGVS expression, the variant in other databases, types of variation, molecular consequences, and allele origin. Most submissions to ClinVar are provided by clinical testing laboratories, but they often lack of knowledge of the patients. Sometimes, clinical providers may submit detailed phenotypes and their own interpretations of the patients with being tested. This kind of information is valuable, so ClinVar distinguishes those submissions as provider interpretation. The detailed phenotypic information of patients can contribute to the aggregation of interpretation and review status of the variant. Also, groups such as patient registries can provide phenotypes of patients, but without interpretations. This type of submission will have the collection method phenotyping only. Next, searching data at the ClinVar website. It is recommended to search for data at ClinVar using the following keywords: gene symbols, HGVS expressions, protein changes, RS numbers, diseases, clinical features and phenotypes, submitters, a location on a chromosome. It is also possible to search for data with the date that the clinical significance was last evaluated, HGNCID or gene ID, and HPOIDs, which represents the ID of human phenotypes. The search result can be filtered by various information, such as clinical significance, review status, allele origin, method type, molecular consequences, variation type, variant length, and variant gene relationship. The improved search function will help users to find data more efficiently. Okay, to sum up. 1. ClinVar is a publicly available archive for sharing variant interpretation and supporting evidence. 2. ClinVar aggregates data by variant disease pairs and by variants. 3. ClinVar data can be accessed through the website and downloaded in XML or VCF formats. 4. Submission with detailed phenotypic information of patients may be included. 5. The search function at the ClinVar website has been improved. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe and click the bell icon to get new video updates. See you next time. Bye.